The epidermis is very, very thin. It's only about the thickness of a sheet of paper, so less than 1 millimeter thick. And there's a lot of cells that are packed in there doing this important job of protecting your body from the external environment.
There are keratinocytes, which are the most common cells, and they start at the bottom, the basal layer.
And then as the cells move up into the upper layers of the epidermis, they do what's called differentiation, and they change their function.
They become more and more plate-like or squamous.
To become more of an effective barrier to the external environment.
And the third type of cell that you see in the epidermis is the melanocyte, the pigment-producing cell. And the melanocyte is obviously extremely important because it provides protection against ultraviolet radiation, which is damaging to the skin.
The sun exposure causes the UV damages, and while our body does its job to repair those damages, chronic sun exposure or intense sun exposure can lead to more damages.
Over time, if those basal cells that live in the basement of the skin develop mutations in their DNA, these are going to get passed along as they're reproducing and repopulating the skin.
More mutations will develop. That cell will then lose all of its control and continue to grow and destroy the surrounding tissue. And that is the definition of cancer.
Skin cancer is typically categorized into non-melanoma skin cancer as well as the melanoma. Non-melanoma skin cancers are most commonly squamous cell carcinoma and basal cell carcinoma.
Basal cell skin cancer tends to grow slowly. It is unlikely to spread or metastasize to other areas in the body, so that's good news. But it is very persistent in its growth, and so while it grows slowly, it can grow to a very large size and be very destructive to surrounding tissues over a period of years.
Unlike basal cell, squamous cell skin cancer can spread outside of the skin and can cause metastasis and mortality for patients.
Melanoma, while being much less common, is more concerning because it has a higher rate of spread.
And melanoma, of course, has historically been a very lethal disease in the advanced stages. However, the good news, and I can't emphasize this enough, that the majority of melanomas are discovered at an early treatable stage, 96%.
Skin cancer can really look like many things and can mimic benign conditions of the skin. And so this is why it's really important to have your biannual screening exam with a board-certified dermatologist, because their trained eye will be able to pick up what is, you know, a skin cancer that needs to be biopsied.
So most skin cancers, especially basal cell and squamous cell skin cancer, can be cured with surgical removal.
We have various surgical approaches to treat skin cancer, which include a standard excision where the skin cancer is removed, sent off to pathology.
If it's a lesion on the body that has a pattern under the microscope where it has little roots, then the Mohs technique, which allows us to excise the tumor in the office and study it while the patient waits, is the preferred approach.
It allows us to assess the margins better. The margins meaning around the skin cancer as well as the base of it. We're able to visualize theoretically 100% of the margins and be more confident that we had removed all the skin cancers.
So most skin cancers will start in the epidermis, but once they become cancerous, they invade into deeper tissues. Mohs surgery allows us to be as precise as possible when we're doing this because we can track that tumor under the microscope as we go. And it allows us to achieve that highest cure rate of making sure we're removing all of the tumor that we can detect, as well as preserving any normal tissues that are nearby and not removing anything more than what we need to.